yo, what's good? Brazy Game. Hey man, it's been a minute since we did a PS5 review on our channel. You know what I'm saying, bro? Now, I'm super excited and curious on what the PS5 has in store for us this year. You know what I'm saying, bro? We already know, bro. We getting new features. We're getting new games. We're getting a whole new, brand new controller. You know what I'm saying, bro? We don't carry batteries over here. You feel me? Sony don't carry batteries, bro. That's so 2000 and outdatedness all around. You know what I'm saying, bro? Xbox, step your freaking game up. And last but not least, bro, we're getting a whole new console model. You feel me? But, bro, I feel like majority of the people that's getting a new console this year, bro, they're going for the PS5, bro. They got to. Nobody wants that big ass little Debbie cake box in their room. Nobody wants that. Sucking up all their energy and air, bro. Nobody wants the Xbox Series X, bro. No cap. You feel me? But with that being said, bro, we got 23 things you need to know about the PlayStation 5, bro. Now, you guys already know I am Sony gang all the way, bro. You know what I'm saying? But with that being said, bro, we are going to go ahead and hop right into this video, man. Let me know down below, who are y'all going with? Are y'all going to be copping the PlayStation 5 or y'all copping the Xbox Series X, bro? You know what I'm saying? AKA the little Debbie cake box. You feel me? Let's get it, bro.
Welcome to PlayStation Access. My name is Nathan.
What's going on, Nathan?
This November,
let's see what the PS5 has in store for us this year, guys. Y'all pay close attention. You know what I'm saying?
A few things to discover over the coming weeks, but for now,
look at that model, bro. It's beautiful.
About PlayStation
Way
5.
Better than Xbox Series X. You know what I'm saying?
If you don't know what PlayStation 5 looks like, it looks like this. Number two, there are two versions of PlayStation 5. The standard edition and the discless digital edition.
Oh yeah.
There are no other changes
one.
In features or power aside from the disc drive. Number three.
Which version y'all getting? For my PS5 fans out there, y'all getting the digital or just the digital with the disc? You know what I'm saying? I still haven't even decided which one I'm going to get. I'm probably going to get the just regular digital version. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't know. I don't really play games on discs like that. Don't buy games like that.
£449
I really download them.
Or £359.99 for the digital edition. Some countries, including the US, will launch a little earlier on the 12th. Number four, we already know of three games.
Bro,
that will
bro,
be free
this
on
bro, GTA
Plus.
Is so Astros. Outdated, bro. I don't know why they keep milking this game, bro. It's getting to the point, bro. I'm getting sick and tired of this. You know what I'm saying? I'm tired of playing GTA 5. Just give us GTA 6. Give us what we want. You know what I'm saying? GTA 5 is annoying, bro. It's been off for 10 plus years,
release,
it feels like.
And we'll highlight
you
the features of the DualSense controller. More on those in a moment. Also at launch, Battle Royale Fortnite will be ready to download for PS5 players who can carry over all their progress and purchases to the
like
new
that,
console.
Bro. I'd be raging
and players
too much
will have
that game,
3 months
bro.
To grab GTA Online for free after its launch as a standalone title in the second half of 2021. Number 5. Speaking of games, plenty of others have been announced, and lots more are coming. But the confirmed launch day lineup from SIE Worldwide Studios is Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales.
That Spider-Man game like it's going to be lit, bro.
Sackboy, A Big Adventure, and Destruction All-Stars. Number 6, also announced for launch, is the PS Plus Collection, a new feature coming to PlayStation Plus on PS5.
The
PS Plus Collection is a curated list of some of the biggest games on PS4, all available to PS5 players with a Plus subscription, giving them access to essential hits like God of War, Uncharted 4.
I never played God of War,
Persona
bro, and that's
5,
very,
Arkham Knight,
very disappointing on my end, you know what I'm saying? Because God of War is like a PlayStation exclusive, bro, and I have never played God of War a day in my life, bro. You know what I'm saying? I have to step my game up,
and as you can see, plenty more.
I really have to step up my game up, bro.
PS5's controller is called
DualSense. Look at that controller, bro.
And it looks like this.
It's beautiful.
Number 8. The reason it's called DualSense instead of DualShock
it's
is
so
because,
refurbished
as well as
and everything,
building on the
bro.
Successful features of DualShock this, 4, it's designed to explore a sense of touch within gameplay, with advanced haptic feedback adding a variety of powerful sensations during play and adaptive triggers built into the R2
and my hands
L2
are fiending, bro. I just can't wait to
levels
get my hands
of resistance
in that controller, bro.
As players press
you know what I'm saying?
Them. Overall, according to PlayStation's Hideaki Nishino, we want gamers to feel like the controller is an extension of themselves when they're playing, so much so that they forget it's even in their hands. Number
wow,
nine,
that's cool.
While we're talking about DualSense,
I never knew that.
The controller uses USB-C and will feature a rechargeable battery. Number 10, let's get into PS5's specs. First of all, the numbers. The official specs list looks like this. The CPU comprises 8 Zen 2 AMD cores running at variable frequency up to 3.5 GHz. All right. The GPU is a custom RDNA 2 based graphics engine with ray tracing acceleration capable of 10.3 teraflops. The system memory is 16 gigabytes of GDDR6 RAM with a 448 gigabytes per second bandwidth. The storage is a custom 825 gigabyte SSD with a 5.5 gigabyte per second raw read bandwidth. And PS5 game discs will be Ultra HD Blu-ray discs with a capacity of up to 100 gigabytes. And now,
that's crazy.
Let's take a look at some of what that actually translates into.
Starting this guy's voice is making it even more better, bro. Even more enthusiasm to buy the PS5.
More space for data when putting games together, but that you can also watch 4K Blu-rays on PlayStation 5. Number 12. Awesome. PS5 CPU, the central processing unit responsible for performing instructions, is an 8-core CPU like PS4's, but based on the more advanced Zen 2 architecture, giving it a clock speed of 3.5 GHz compared to PlayStation 4's 1.6 GHz. In terms of raw processing power, it's more than double. 13. PS5's powerful allow for higher resolution in games as well as supporting ray tracing.
That spider, though.
It simulates the way light moves in real life. So games that take advantage of ray tracing will render objects like water, glass, and even hair more realistically.
Oh, that
14,
is cool, bro. I can't wait, bro.
Significant advances.
I think PS5 is going to outdo Xbox Series X this year, you know what I'm saying? 100% without a doubt, you know what I'm saying? I just feel bad for all the Xbox, diehard Xbox fans, bro, that just can't get over that your console is not up to par with Sony, bro. It's not, bro. Y'all still carry batteries. You feel me? Like, that's a whole minus right there, bro. That's a hint.
Down to the console storage, that ultra-high speed SSD, and a connecting interface designed to optimize the speed at which data can be pushed through the system. The objective is for using PS5 to feel seamless and dynamic with larger, richer game worlds and much shorter load times. At an event
The
PlayStation 5 system architect explained that PS5's SSD would reach speeds of at least 5 gigabytes per second compared to the PlayStation 4's 100 megabytes per second, and that the aim is to reduce PS5 load times to 2 gigabytes.
Yes, bro, we need that, bro. With that being said, bro, what he just said, bro, we do need that reduced load time. You know what I'm saying? Now, I remember when the PS4 first came out, you feel me? Everybody was saying PS4 would have no load time whatsoever. You know what I'm saying? Now, I really hope this PS5 load time is close to nothing, because when you're really trying to get something done in the game, and loading really gets in the way of that. You know what I'm saying? It gets kind of annoying and it gets to be a drag.
20 seconds.
So I hope they...
Number 15, PS5 storage will also have other advantages for gamers.
Shorten the load time.
Sony talked about configurable installation, which means installing games in segments. So players might be able to install or remove the campaign or multiplayer section of a game to
save space. Oh, that's fire. I didn't even know that. That's fire.
16. According to Sony's presentation, PlayStation 5 storage can be expanded with an off-the-shelf drive, similar to how things work on PS4. Although it's important to bear in mind that as PlayStation 5 uses what is for now a cutting-edge piece of SSD hardware, many drives won't be fast enough to keep up with the PS5 systems. PlayStation will be validating hard drives that are suitable for use in PS5 over time. Number 17, PS5 will feature a custom 3D audio engine, offering a deeper sense of immersion through sounds and a greater sense of presence and locality. The system is called Tempest, and according to Hideaki Noshino again, you'll be able to hear raindrops hitting different surfaces all around you, and you can hear and precisely locate where an enemy is lurking behind you.
Bro, that is a plus right there, bro. That is such a plus, you know what I'm saying? For our Call of Duty players out there, bro, Fortnite players, our shooters, you know what I'm saying? I'm a shooter player, you feel me? Play all types of games, but... Bro, that's a plus, you know what I'm saying? Just in case someone try to sneak up behind you, bro, you can hear it from the back of your head. That is a plus, bro. Thank you, Sony, for adding that feature to the PlayStation 5, bro.
PlayStation
we really do need
announced
that.
The Pulse 3D wireless headset
that's
for PS5,
lit, bro. That
which
is
will
very
feature
lit.
3D audio and noise-canceling microphones. 19.
Awesome.
Actually, a whole lineup of PS5 accessories has been announced. In addition to the Pulse 3D wireless headset and the DualSense wireless controller, there is a charging station with space for two controllers, a media remote, and a camera. 20, the new HD camera features two 1080p lenses, an improvement over the PS4 camera's maximum resolution of 1280 by 800.
Well, that is beautiful.
21, while we're talking about hardware accessories,
they got a VR?
It is confirmed that PSVR will also be compatible with PS5. Number 22, PS5 will be backwards compatible with the overwhelming majority of PS4 games. Based on testing, PlayStation expects...
I mean, that's fine, bro, but I'm kind of salty that Xbox is compatible all the way to the original Xbox, bro. I'm really, really salty Sony didn't add that feature, you know what I'm saying? But that's the only thing that, you know, that's keeping me...
Titles will be
it ain't something big, but I would love to go back and play on, like, regular PlayStation games, you
coverage coming over time. And number 23, PlayStation has confirmed that where its games are available on both PS4 and PS5, like Sackboy: A Big Adventure, there will be a free upgrade option available to players when they make the move to PS5.
Oh, wow.
And that's everything you need to know about PlayStation 5.
All right, Brazy Gang, that's going to cap it off for today's video, man. Let me know down below, are y'all Team Sony or Team Microsoft, Team PlayStation or Team Xbox, man? I want to see some debates down below, bro. Who are y'all rocking with? You know what I'm saying? But last but not least, bro, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you smack that like button for your boy. And if you made it to this end of the video and you're new to my channel and you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, bro, go ahead and hit that subscribe button to join Brazy Gang. We up our 2020, man. We almost there at 1K subscribers, bro. So share this video with a friend so we can get there faster, bro. And that's all I gotta say, bro. I love y'all, man. I'm gonna see y'all in the next video, bro. Brazy Zay out, man.